So this is the sixth lesson of our financial modeling course, and we've now pretty much completed our financial model. But what is important is that our spreadsheet is professional looking. So in this lesson, we are improving the formatting of our financial model. That's basically already the end of this financial model. So we now have projected our cash flows, but I think there are two more important things that I want to do in this lesson. The first thing I want to do is I want to see how much Thanos can actually pay to achieve the target return. So up until now, we modeled the 90 million euros for the purchase price. However, what we can see is that based on the 90 million ask, you can see that the return that Thanos is delivering is only 8.4%. So one of the main questions of this case study was, well, can Thanos pay 90 million euros and achieve a 20% IR? And the answer therefore is no, they can't. The next question then is, well, can they actually pay, or how much can they actually pay to deliver a 20% IRR and a 2x equity multiple? So what is the price that Thanos can pay? And then ultimately there will be sort of some sort of negotiation between the vendor and the buyer, which in this case is Thanos, to determine whether or not a deal can be struck. But the first thing we need to establish is how much can Thanos actually pay to achieve their target returns. The other thing that I want to do, and I actually want to do this first, is I want to make sure that our model looks really professional. So it's always important to have a professional looking financial model, because you know, you want to work for a professional, a sophisticated real estate investment firm, and it's important therefore that your cash flows look really good. Let's start off by improving the formatting. Okay, and there are a couple of things I want to do. So the first thing I want to do is I want to add a column here, and I change the width to 2. Okay, and I change the width to the right as well. I select the column Alt H O W and I change the width to 2. Okay, now I set the print area. How do I set the print area? Well, I highlight the area that I want to select by clicking Shift and then the arrow key on my keyboard. Okay, I highlight the area. There you go. And then I click on Alt PRS. Okay. And now I've set the print area. Okay. And now I click on Alt WI. There you go. So now I've set the print area. But what you can see is you can see those dashed lines everywhere here, right? Which means that the print area is spread over, in this case, over 6 pages. We don't want that. So therefore we go on the page setup, Alt PSP, and we click in this case on portray and fit to one page. Okay, now we can see what it looks like. Let's have a look. And so this is already not too bad, but it's not perfect. And there are a couple of things that bother me about this. The first thing that you can see is that the borders are pretty wide. So let's remove the borders. So I go Alt PSP, I go to margin, and I put the borders to 0.5 everywhere. 0.5, 0.5, and to the top the same, and to the bottom as well. Okay, let's go to the print area. And so this already looks a little bit better. But the one thing that I don't like is that the font is really small. So it's really hard to read. So what I want to make sure is I want to make sure that I can see everything quite clearly when I print out the page. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to group the columns in this case that I don't actually need. Okay, so I group them. There you go, Alt HEG, I grouped them, and now it looks like this. Okay, so this already looks much better. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to add a total column here. Okay, and the total columns are really handy because they allow me to very quickly understand sort of the magnitude of each of those lines of the cash flow. So I put NA here for the rents per square meter and the occupancy, but then I sum up the total cash flows here. So the cash flows that impact my investment profile. Okay, and I put a border here. And I do the same here to the bottom. Total, let's copy this over. Total, make sure all the subtotals are shaded in gray. I have a top border here as well. And if you look at this now, this looks really nice, right? Okay. The next thing I want to do is I want to remove the grid lines. Alt W and I go to VG. And now you don't see the grid lines. This is a matter of personal preference. Some people like to see the grid lines, some people don't. And the next thing I want to do is I want to have a separator line between the time when we buy the asset and the actual cash flows. And I put a dashed border around it here to the left. Dashed border. Okay. And then dashed border. And the final thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put in headers and footers. Well, actually only footers. So how can I do this? I go to page setup, custom footer, and now I put something there just because I feel it makes it look really professional. So I type in RIA, the Real Estate Investment Academy. I make sure the font is right. Here, play fair display, there you go. And I change the font size to, let's say, 8. Okay, and here I say something like proprietary materials or something like this. Okay, and I change the font size to 8 as well. And I leave it like this. And then here I add the page number. And I change the font size also to 8. Okay. Perfect. And now if I go to page setup, let's see what it looks like. Yeah, so now you can see at the bottom here, you can see that I've got the footers as well, the page number, and it's nicely formatted and everything is clearly visible. The last thing I want to do now is I want to make sure there are no typos. So I click on F7. This is not a typo. Ignore, and done. So no typos here. Okay, so now as you can see, let's click again on Control P. So now I can actually print this out and see what my cash flow profile looks like. So in my opinion, this looks really neat and professional. It's a very simple one page back of the envelope cash flow profile. So it's really simple and very basic. Mainly because there's only one long-term lease. So there's no need to have things really sort of to have a more complicated cash flow profile. And this is probably really everything we need for a simple back of the envelope cash flow model. But the one most important question still remains, which is how much can Thanos actually pay? So we're currently modeling 90 million euros. And you can see the returns that Thanos is achieving are 8.4% IRR, but the target returns are 20% IRR.